It's a raccoon with a talk show, slinging culture facts you might not know. From the biggest flops to the greatest hits, this is Trash Can Tidbits.
Hey everybody, it's Beaton here, and welcome to the 18th installment of Trash Can Tidbits. This week I thought I'd do something a little different and see what you guys think of a product review. Now, as you probably know, Disney let loose their Disney Plus streaming service last week, and despite some initial hesitation, I ultimately pre-ordered and signed up for it. So this week, I'm going to delve into 10 things that I like and don't like about it. 5 things for each. Think of this as like a first impressions video. If you don't have Disney Plus for yourself yet, maybe this will be a factor for you deciding to get it or not. So, let's get started with what I do like about Disney Plus. 1. I can download it on all of my devices. I already have Disney Plus downloaded on my smart TV, PS4, phone, tablet, and Roku streaming stick. I like to take my Roku with me on vacation or to cons, so this will be a great app to have along with it. Plus, I can download Disney content onto my tablet in case of a long plane or train ride, so I will always be entertained when I need my Disney fix. 2. I love that Disney is making their own original content. I already have been getting into their new Star Wars series, The Mandalorian, and I really can't wait to see more. Plus, with all the Marvel shows on the way like Ms. Marvel, She-Hulk, What If, and The Falcon and the Winter Soldier, there really is no limit as to what can come next, and how everything will tie into the MCU. 3. It's affordable for me at $6.99 a month. Other streaming services will most likely charge you more based on extra content, but everything that you need is right here and when you need it. And if you already have an account with Hulu or ESPN, you can link your account to have a bundle package that's worth $12.99. I was curious about that, so on a whim, I decided to see how this bundle actually worked, and I got the surprise of my life. I was able to link my Hulu account, and it gave me enough credit for even having the previous account that brought my billing down to just 1 cent. Now, I don't know about you, but that's more than enough. When I saw the statement, my mouth literally dropped open. I sincerely hope that's a monthly thing, because I was like, phew, sold. 4. You can watch in HDR or 4K. There is nothing I love more than picture detail and high quality images. Even some of the shows I've watched have gotten a little bit of an HD facelift, particularly Chip and Dale Rescue Rangers, Bonkers, Timon and Pumbaa, and Gargoyles, among others. These are shows that have not been seen on Blu-ray at all, let alone on DVD for most of them. And it's really refreshing to see shows from my childhood get the high-quality boost they need, even the more obscure shows. And quite possibly the best part, Zootopia in 4K? Yes, please! 5. Disclaimers and content warnings for the more serious parts of the Disney canon. This is probably the biggest point of contention I was concerned with when the service was getting ready to launch. Disney announced that they were going to be editing out characters and content that could be seen as offensive to today's viewers, particularly the crows from Dumbo. Not only would that have been a huge mistake, you would lose a huge plot point for Dumbo, as the crows are the ones who teach him how to fly. I was, and still am, a big proponent of placing a content warning label in front of films that warn audiences that these character tropes were of their time and can be seen as offensive. But they would be presented as they were, because erasing them would be the same as claiming they never existed in the first place. I'm really happy that Disney changed their minds and allowed the crows, the Siamese cats from Lady and the Tramp, and the Indians from Peter Pan, among others, to remain the way they are, because, let's be honest, I'm a budding film historian, and those edits would not only have pissed me off, but other film buffs as well. Now let's move on to 5 things that I don't like about Disney+. 6. Despite the content warning attached to most of these movies, Disney will still not release Song of the South, one of, if not the most infamous films in the Disney canon. I mean, if you're going to release merchandise of the characters and continue to feature them on Splash Mountain, why not release Song of the South? It just doesn't make any sense that they're saying that they're going to release every Disney movie on the service when in actuality they're not. 7. Also, there are quite a few movies that are missing some content. 3 of them in particular I'm really miffed about. The first is Bedknobs and Broomsticks. which had an extended restored cut released in 1997 with about 30 minutes of found footage. That cut has sadly never been released on Blu-ray, and it's since reverted back to the version from my childhood that's under 2 hours. I very much prefer the restored version. The second film is The Muppet Christmas Carol, and there's a song missing that's only available on the full-screen DVD called When Love Is Gone. The scene loses some of its context without the song, and makes the scene feel so incomplete as a result. The final movie is Pocahontas, again missing a song, in this case, the love duet, If I Never Knew You. Yes, it's a sad song, but it makes John Smith's situation towards the end of the movie much more meaningful. You can view the song in the film on the 10th anniversary DVD, but it hasn't been seen in the movie since. Now, these were just some of the edits that I found, but I'm sure there are many more as time goes along. 8. Though there is a great feeling to have almost every Disney movie and TV show at your fingertips, there is something even more satisfying to own a physical copy of them on Blu-ray. I don't know what it is. It's similar to reading a book. You just don't get the same sensation by swiping a screen when you're reading from a tablet. This is just a minor thing, but it's really nothing I can't handle. I mean, some content you just can't get anywhere else, you might as well give it a try. 9. Because of the upscale to HD, some scenes lose just a little bit in quality. For example, if a movie was not originally made in letterbox format, it may be stretched out slightly to fit the screen, yet still look a bit unnatural. Movies like Lady and the Tramp and Sleeping Beauty were made with widescreen in mind, so it's not a big issue if it's presented that way. If anything, there is the occasional graininess due to the 4K transfer. There are still plenty of movies that were not made in letterbox format or widescreen and still have to be stretched out farther to compensate. Some of the older TV content like Rescue Rangers and Gargoyles have been given the HD treatment and are therefore presented in widescreen, but others like Darkwing Duck are not. It's not a big problem unless you have major issues with it, which I don't really, but I thought it was worth mentioning anyway. 10. Finally, with any new product or service launch, you have to anticipate how many people will actually use it on day one. I'm definitely sure I wasn't the only one who had this problem. The issues are minor now, but when I began to use it, the connectivity issues were all over the place. Sometimes I got to the main menu, other times content was missing and I couldn't access anything. Sometimes I even had to log in again. However, this issue was also pretty minor, as it was just a temporary inconvenience and the service was up and running within a few hours. Launching a new product is always pretty risky, and I don't think Disney could have anticipated the high volume that they get. I mean, even companies like Sony and Nintendo have had problems like this, but it's pretty easily fixable. Unless something outright just crashes the system and breaks everything. I'm looking at you, Wreck-It Ralph. And there we go for this week. All in all, I'm really loving this service, and there's always room for improvement. I have a feeling that it's just going to get better from here on out. Disney has always been one of the kings of high-quality entertainment, and Disney Plus is really their most ambitious project yet. I have barely just begun. I hope you like this installment, and I'd totally love to do more videos like this where I do reviews and give first impressions. If there's anything you'd love me to take a look at, please comment below. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm gonna go catch up on some further Disney Afternoon programming. Please don't forget to like, subscribe, share, and give that notification bell out there a boop. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.